Greetings and welcome to Ingrid's Insights. Hi, my name is Ingrid and I will be doing a reading for the sign of Virgo, sun, moon, and rising. And how are you out there? And I'm so happy for you to be joining me today for this reading. And let's get some tarot cards to get started and see how is my Virgo doing. Well, the first card off the bat is the Devil. That's you. Have a question, concern. You're the querent here, inquiring into something. And this is saying that you are, or the situation is somewhat devilish. Is there something going on out there, Virgo, for you? It's saying that you could be feeling right now in bondage to something that's keeping you in a miserable state of suffering and bondage and fear, trapped in a toxic relationship or toxic work situation, or just the people around you are very materialistic, and there's this absence of anything other than just going for what you want, a kind of narcissistic reality where it's just people use each other and as narcissistic appendages. And it's saying that, is there an addiction? Is there something toxic that you have to look at? Because that's what you're bringing here, Virgo. And your challenge, or what could help you, is celebrating with friends, raising your glass, having a good time, partying. But maybe since this is with the Devil, it could say, well, maybe there's too much partying. Maybe there could be alcohol involved, or alcohol and drugs, or that you're, when you get around family and friends, you get tend to be pulled back into those toxic situations. Even on the surface, they might look fun, or the gathering might be, you know, something that has a celebratory, festive nature, but it's saying that something has to be left behind because it's toxic, it's not serving you. And at the foundation is the Eight of Wands. It's saying at the foundation, something at the very root of this question is moving fast. You're getting a lot of energy. It's saying whatever you have been thinking about this Devil and celebrating and partying and gatherings with togetherness, it's saying you're moving fast at the foundation. Something is moving fast. Something about this situation, maybe that you weren't really clear about, is coming to light quickly, and you're moving on, because what you're seeing at the crown is the Knight of Wands. Wow, he burst in on the scenes, charismatic, going for what he wants or she wants with courage and flamboyance, flames. This is a Leo, an Aries, a Sagittarius, travel, on the move. So these are two very quick cards, both in the suit of wands, which is energy, passion, desire. And then you got this Devil, which is all about seduction and keeping us trapped in these things of the party realm, but maybe that aren't really serving us. Because what's in the recent past is the Six of Swords. And the Six of Swords says in the recent past, you've just, Virgo, gotten out of some difficult situation, some trapped situation. And you see how the Devil is looking back at that trap that the Devil had you in, whatever that was. And you have moved on to safety. You moved to another place. You're traveling for rest and recuperation because you're getting the hell out of there where this Devil was. And you're getting out of there fast, because what's coming is the Page of Wands. So, wow, you've got a progression. You're going from the Eight of Wands to the Page of Wands, which is quick energy, which is adventure, wanting to go out, ready to move on from where you were. And this stuck situation is saying you're moving, and you're moving with this adventuresome passion, going toward Virgo, what you want now, and having that confidence and charisma to do it, to go for it. And you've got at the crown as what a possible outcome is this Knight of Wands who goes quickly toward what they want. And this is you in this situation, how you see you, Virgo. Ah, the King of Pentacles. Well, you see yourself as someone who's worked hard and has a lot of security financially, is able to make good investments and watch your money grow and manage your money and manage that, help other people in that realm to sit confidently and with gratitude and generosity. And this is somebody who has worked hard for this pentacle, which is wealth. And who is around you, what your situation is the Nine of Cups. Well, you've got both the Three of Cups and the Nine of Cups as there's a lot of celebration going on. There's a lot of happiness with others and joy. This is a wish fulfillment card that you have been wishing, Virgo, for something recently, and now, wow, it's coming to pass and in your environment. That's what the people around you see is a lot of wealth and a lot of contentment and abundance in the realm of celebrating and passion and parties, enjoyment, contentment. Because your hope and fear is the Two of Cups. Your hope and fear is for a union, for yourself to come together with another, a soulmate, a twin flame, something. Your hope and fear is love, and love with another that will be passionate, that you will come quickly, that will take you on adventures, that will have a lot of wealth and celebration and contentment, wishes coming true. And that's what your hope and fear is, that you will have that union, that love, another person, a relationship. And if you're not looking for a relationship with another person, it's that joining of those masculine and feminine feelings within yourself and bringing those together. But you both hope and fear the union and love, because the advisor is the Hermit, and that's Virgo, your card. The Hermit is saying you are being asked as the advice to go off in solitude, to you still need to follow your star and follow that guidance, to maybe you need to retreat and understand something about the devil, about what that. Because that's in the position of this question, these attachments, what you're in bondage to, what you're addicted to, what is toxic, and learn from that and move. This is you, the Virgo, going into the forest, self-knowledge, study, taking time to yourself to understand who you are. And that's what's coming in February. Wow, so let's just recap for a moment. There is, as you come into this reading, there's a sense of the devil, some demonic force of this material world that's attaching to you or that you're in bondage to, and that you have to look at this devil. It could be have to do with the way you join with other people, what you've been celebrating, parties, family affairs. And what is at the foundation is something very energetic and moving fast and moving forward toward your goals. and you've got this passionate Knight of Wands boldly taking you there with charisma, cockiness, a creative energy, fire. It could be a Leo, Aries, Sagittarius involved. And this could be a Capricorn involved with the Devil. And what is passing is the a Six of Swords. You come out of some nightmarish situation you thought you would never be in, something where nothing was working out and you felt like that you were being hurt by others, or you had couldn't figure out how to make this work, and finally you're being taken divine guidance to safer waters. And the safer waters is this Knight of Wands, this energy to move forward on a new adventure, to go for your what you want, and to take that creative energy and little inkling of a passion or idea and go with it. And you've got all the financial wealth and stability and security that you need. And you, the people around you are very happy, living the dream, having wish fulfillments here and there, celebrating. And your hope and fear is, oh, will I have union? Will I find my soulmate? Will I join with those, the love within myself, for myself? And the advice is, this is you, Virgo. This is your card. You're the Hermit. Follow that inner knowledge. Know thyself. Learn. Take time out. Go on a retreat. Be alone. And find that inner light within you and follow that star. So that is my reading for you today, Virgo, for the bonus reading for February. And let's follow up with a few of our angel oracle cards just to get some summary of this reading. So angels are all around us, guiding us, protecting us, and loving us, supporting us, healing us. And what is it that the angel oracles want Virgo to know today? What does my Virgo need to know? Power intention. That is a way to heal from the devil, to find your own inner power and follow that intention toward what it is that you truly lights your fire, what brings you confidence, makes you feel energetic and charismatic and full of life. And what is the power intention for? To take charge and action. Wow, well, you had that Eight of Wands, the Knight of Wands, the Page of Wands. So you're taking that power intention and you're taking charge and action, Virgo, as you move into February. And you're looking for signs and reminders all around. So look for those synchronicities. Follow your intuitions, those hunches. And like I advise with my channel, Ingrid's Insights, take those inklings, these butterflies, birds, clouds, rainbows, stars, moon, anything that you see, take those in, Virgo, in this month, and really let that give you power and keep your intentions to take charge and action. And that's beautiful. And we'll get one dream decoder. What do your dreams say? What do the unconscious mind that we connect to when we sleep and dream, what does it want to you to know? What does my Virgo need to know? Actor celebrity. Wow. Well, Virgo, an actor celebrity is coming into your dreams, out of your subconscious mind. When a celebrity or actor or even a historical figure appears in a dream, the significance may lie in what they are famous for. their personality or behavior, or the way they project themselves to others. Wow. Appearing as a star may be a warning against self-importance, though, Virgo. Conversely, being a supporting actor may mean you should put yourself center stage more. So think of celebrities and what they mean to you, being an actor. And that could be something coming up from your unconscious that you need to be aware of now. So I hope you enjoyed this reading. And if you did, Virgo, please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. And visit me at ingrisinsights.com for a personal reading. And you know I love you. And thank you for being here all together in this interconnected field, learning and growing and watching for signs and reminders that the spirits are around us, taking charge and action of our life, moving beyond those toxicities, and using power and intention. Well, a beautiful reading, and good to see you. Bye-bye, Virgo.